After 2 months of negotiations and waiting for the current tenants to vacate, we finally settled on a price of $307,000. With comps in the high threes, we stand to make a decent profit. But if the structure in the back can be permitted as a livable space, we'll make some serious cash. Our contractor is meeting us at the house today, and we're finally getting our first look inside.
All right, she's open.
Woo!
Well, it's tiny.
Wow. Just looking in this room, I see that we might have some issues with some plugs that may not be grounded.
Yeah, we would definitely
have to figure something out. At the kitchen. Woof. Yikes.
Okay, well, the good news is it's a small kitchen, which means it's not going to be expensive. Not many cabinets.
Very small kitchen. The bad news is it's a small kitchen.
What we can do to improve the value would be to open up the kitchen.
Yes, mm-hmm. For sure.
What if we remove this entire wall, opening up the kitchen? Close this door off and run uppers and lowers. What are we looking at?
Best case scenario, we're looking right around 5,500.
Wow.
Really, this house just has to have a nice kitchen, has to have a nice bathroom. All right, so this is the only bathroom in the house.
Yuck.
Oh, gosh.
Ooh, look at the ceiling.
Oh. All right, so full gun here. Just give me a ballpark.
Yeah, maybe 3,800. Now here's where I see an electrical issue. If you look down at the ground, you have outlets that are literally at the ground.
Right, and that can be a fire hazard.
Based on what we're walking, I mean, what would you say worst case if we needed to rewire the whole house?
Right around 4,000.
Okay, so electric's gonna be an issue. That's the garage.
The room connects to the garage?
Huh. A little weird. Old house charm for you.
What in the world is this thing?
So when you pull into the garage, you enter to a bedroom?
Yeah.
That's really weird. A bedroom that opens into a garage? I do not like this place. The layout is awkward and the rooms are tiny. And no matter what we do to redesign this place, it won't change the fact that it's less than 900 square feet. Let's just hope the structure in the backyard adds value. Oh.
What
is this? How creepy and strange.
What in the world is all this stuff back here?
It's like an old junkyard.
The structure's huge.
There's a chain on there, man.
Oh my God. Christina, you could probably squeeze through this.
Even if I could, there's not a chance that I would ever go in there by myself.
Pretty creepy in here.
Oh my God.
Ugh. Oh! Dude, you all right?
I'm okay.
You okay.
I didn't see that. I was almost crushed by a giant pile of junk.
Jeez. Well, let's see if we can get a door open in here, man. Get some light. Let's see what can we actually see in this place.
I feel like we're gonna find dead bodies in here.
Oh no.
Someone lived in here. I've never seen anything like
that. What is it? Like a workshop? This place is huge. It's like 3 times the size of the main house.
We need to go to the city, find out what the zoning is on this property, find out if we can turn this into living square footage. It already has a kitchen, it has a bathroom, and go from there. If we can convert this into living space, huge benefit. I mean, 2 houses on a lot. If we can't, I don't even know if this brings value.
How are you?
Hi.
Liking the place?
No.
Oh, man.
Did you go to the city, and can we convert this to living space?
Unfortunately, we cannot.
No, really?
No. This one's zoned R1, so we can only have 1 livable dwelling on this lot. Now, it is permitted to have a home office or a home business, so somebody could work out of here. And get this. The bathroom is permitted.
No, it's not.
What?
That thing is not permitted. Are you serious?
It's the only other thing that's on the permits.
So we could turn this into an auto shop. They can put a little waiting area here with the TV.
It's disappointing that this backspace can't be permitted. Our best bet is to leave it as a blank canvas and let the buyer decide what it should be. Our only hope now is to make the front house as nice as we can. Really good.
Looks good, right?
Yeah.
The brown goes good with the white cabinets, the gray quartz.
Definitely.
You like the pink color?
Yeah.
I mean, I love the color, but how do you feel about the trim? It's like purple.
I actually think it's really nice.
You think?
Yeah, I think it's really pretty. I like the fact that we did the garage door the same color as the trim.
All right, well, at least this huge garage looks better.
Yeah, it does look better. I'm glad we did the same color as the house.
I'm gonna be honest here. This is purple. The trim?
I like lavender, so that's probably why I like it.
So we have a lime green and lavender house.
Is the gate pink too? Got a pink gate and a
pink gate,
purple garage.
Purple trim, purple garage.
It sounds like my car started.
There's your car.
Is there someone in my car? Oh my God, what the hell? What? How'd they get my keys?
Hey!
Tarek, how'd they start the car?
The keys are in your purse.
Where's my purse?
Where did you put it?
I don't know.
Our car just got stolen. Really? Turns out I tossed the keys in Christina's purse, which she then set onto the porch. This guy saw the purse, found the keys, and made off with our car.
Our car was just stolen from the front of the house.
We called the police, and they're out looking for it right now, but it's not looking good.
Oh my God, what are we gonna do?
Between the creepy shed, the problems with the kitchen, and our car being stolen, a lot of weird stuff has happened with this flip. We're just really anxious to finally put this house on the market. I mean, the kitchen actually is nice. That island that we thought was a major problem, once we install the stove, it really comes together, and there's actually counter space.
It does look a lot better than it did a few weeks ago. And we created an open floor plan. So now when you stand here at the island, you can look directly to the dining room, and you also have a direct view of the living room. So it really does make it feel bigger.
Right.
Remember all the junk that was out here before? My only hope is that this structure doesn't deter buyers in the area.
Yeah, well, we're gonna find out today.
It looks nice.
Nice garden.
Yeah.
I like the color. It's good landscaping in the front,
too. Yeah, the landscaping's cute.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on
in. Hi, how are
you? I'm Christina.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, I'm Nikki.
I'm Nick.
So this house is a two-bedroom, one bath. It's almost 900 square feet. It's listed at $409,000.
We're realtors in the area. We work this area a lot, so we're just, checking things out.
I like how it's bright and airy.
Nice lights.
A little bit on the small side, but super functional still. And the subway tile and the white cabinets keep it feeling open.
The lines that go this way really makes the home flow.
This is nice. The white subway tile really opens it up. I mean, it's small, but it is a really good use of space.
This is the master, I guess.
Bigger than the last one.
Yeah. Some door. Holy cow.
So the dad could do mechanic work in here.
Oh,
work on the car.
I can see all of his tools hanging on the wall.
This is my room.
Is it yours? How about it's our room? We make it the man cave.
Yes.
This could be our future garage house.
So what do you guys think?
I like it. It looks really neat. Yeah. I like the back shed. My husband does mechanic work, so.
That could be perfect for him, though.
Yeah, give us a call, and we'd love to work with you on an offer.
All right, thank you.
Thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
Bye. Thanks.
Can you believe it? We actually found a buyer that likes that thing. Well, it only takes one buyer, honey.
Hopefully that one buyer will write an offer soon.
And we can get our car back. After a week on the market, we received a full price offer for $409,900. If this deal goes through, we'll make a profit of over $49,000. And we got more good news from the police, who recovered our stolen car. Time to find another house to flip.